Welcome this afternoon for another lecture session here at the Red Bull Music Academy. Today, we're very, very happy and honored to have with us a legend. This is a record that came out in 1972 in Brazil, out of Rio de Janeiro. And the genius behind this record is here on the couch with us today. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Arthur Verocai. Now, Arthur has traveled a very long way to get here, and as many of us have, and we all remember how that first day was after we traveled. So we're going to just take it very slowly, like the rhythms of Brazil. We're going to take it very slow today and hear a lot of music, hear a lot of history. And Mr. Verocai is also going to grace us with his beautiful guitar and his beautiful stylings. So,
thank you very much. Thank you to Red Bull and all great people who are here. I am glad to meet all of you, yours. And thank you for all. I don't speak English very well, but it's a surprise to me to meet so many people, or nice people and sympathetic. Thank you very much.
So, Arthur, why don't we start with what was it like for you growing up, coming of age during the 1960s in Brazil? There was a lot of music. There was a very repressive government. There was a lot of things happening. What was it like for you to be a young person in the 60s?
I began to play in the 60 years. Mm-hmm. I was listened and many styles of music, you know. But I begin to play in bossa nova. Mm. I am son of bossa nova. Mm. And the dictatorship was in the Brazilian in that time. And the people live in that regime. And the many musics are lyrics to censored, mm-hmm. and the many composers don't making music and don't releasing this music because the government censored the lyrics. Mm-hmm. And many composers say the things indirectly.
Indirectly. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that is what about?
Yeah.
Do you say?
We will talk about probably some of the songs on your record that talked about that. But I'm also interested in, you said you were son of bossa nova.
Yeah. I begin my first music record was by Lenny Andrade. No?
Lenny Andrade, yeah.
A great singer, Brazilian singer.
Yeah. And you were only 21, yeah? Or even younger?
Yeah.
Yeah, when you were doing that?
Yeah, I don't remember how age I was, uh-huh. but
very young.
Yeah, very young. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But after this, I participate of the music festivals. With my songs. And in 1969. In 70, I make my first, 69, I made my first arrangement, mm-hmm. because I use my music in festival to show my arrangements. Mm. I mm-hmm. began to make I make the arrangements to my songs. Mm. And then another people, another composers like, and I begin my career of arrangement with my songs.
What types of ideas went into your arrangements at the time? I know that you
had
a lot of training, yeah?
The time Bert Bacharach make much success.
Bert Bacharach.
Have to Jimmy Webb, yeah?
Jimmy Webb?
Jimmy Webb, yeah.
He's a country artist.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And it's American, no?
Yeah.
People, no? And in Brazil, have the people of the Bossa Nova, no? Tom Jobim, Lenny Andrade, and the others, and others. Mm. And but the festival was I used the festival to grow up in my career of arrangement.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to play for us any one of the songs that you might have written or that that influenced you?
Yeah, I will play a song. It was the International Festival of Rio.
Ah, okay. Let's put this microphone over. What is the song called?
Saudade Demais, the song, the title. Is,
Saudade Demais.
The lyrics is Paulinho Tapajós, Little Paul. Paulinho Tapajós.
Yes.
Ah. thanks. Yeah.
Now, saudade demais.
Saudade demais.
That means sort of a feeling, like a bluesy type of feeling for home, huh? Something like that? How would you
blues
translate? No? Like
No, it have a harmony, a Brazilian harmony,
yeah.
I think so. Not blues, this.
Oh, no. I meant the idea, the name of the song.
Ah, the name.
Yeah.
So that miss.
Uh-huh.
To miss.
To miss something.
Too much miss. Too
missing
much,
it.
Missing too much.
Too much, yeah. Uh-huh.
Missing too much.
I see. A lot of the Bossa Nova songs are very much songs of, I guess, yearning, of deep feeling, yeah?
Yeah.
And it seems interesting to me that you would have this music at a time when the government was so repressive, when the dictatorship was so strong.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah. Bossa Nova begin before the
dictatorship.
Mm-hmm. Begin before. In some time that Brazilian was the first champion, football championship of international, World Cup, no?
Right, yeah.
And the first a festival of movie, Cannes, Festival de Cannes, mm-hmm. Cannes Festival of
Cannes
Movies.
Festival, yeah, film festival.
Brazil was great growing up, cultural grown up.
Mm-hmm.
And in many parts of the cultural life are the first car fabricated in Brazil, the industry beginning. And was the have the people to vote to president, and have many good things in Brazil in that time.
Mm-hmm.
Bossa Nova was a fruit of this.
Of this.
Grown up cultural.
Period, yeah.
Could have some genius in Bossa Nova, né? Antônio Carlos Jobim, mm-hmm. For the best, the more genius.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, by the time that you begin to work in the festivals, there's a lot of music that's coming from all over the world that you're listening to. You had mentioned you're very much into Stan Kenton and the rock and the jazz and all these different kinds of. How did that fit into your bossa nova background and foundation?
When I begin make the my arrangements, I begin to have a group in the Polygram as a company, mm-hmm. that I begin named O Terço. It's like Beatles, this group.
Like the
and
Beatles.
I make my first recording arrangements by O Terço. Huh. And O Terço, after Ivan Lins, he is beginning with a soul, a type of soul music, not soul music.
Okay.
But a type who mixed Brazilian samba with soul. And it's particular. Mm-hmm. Now Ivan Lins is not soul, no, don't have more, nothing of soul. But soul was beginning in the influence in the Brazilian music, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. in the Tim Maia, do you know?
Tim Maia.
Tim Maia,
oh yeah,
is a great soul music, Brazilian soul music.
And you said Edge Mota.
Yeah, it's uncle of Edge Mota.
Right.
Uh-huh. Uncle Edge Mota is a new generation. No?
Uh huh. Yeah.
And that time, having the world, the Beatles have. Baccarat and many influence, Frank Zappa.
Frank Zappa.
And the bands, the mm-hmm. great bands, Stan Kenton that you said.
Yes.
Right? Uh-huh. And everything this to influence me, to give me. I love music, no?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I loved all types of music. Então. And when I recorded this album, I used all the things that I liked.
All the influences.
This happened, the first synthesizer that go to Rio de Janeiro. The effects, the effects in Caboclo.
Oh, okay.
And the first synthesizer who came to go to Brazil.
Yeah?
The first Brazilian people who buy a synthesizer.
Aha. Uh-huh.
First record.
Shall we play that?
Well, if you want.
What do you think? Should we play that? Okay, let's play it. This is Caboclo. So tell us how you compose that, how you put that song together. Did it start from the guitar? Did it start from the vocal line? Did it start from what did it start from?
At that time, we recorded in four channels only.
Four tracks.
Four tracks only.
That was four tracks. Wow.
It's the first time we recorded guitar, bass, and drums, and percussion in two tracks.
On two tracks.
And
how did you have
more
that?
True.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. How did you separate the two tracks? Which was on which track?
But have a good engineer of sound in Brazil, like name it. He's dead now, but mm-hmm. Salinho,
okay.
Célio, okay. Moreira, Salinho. Salinho, he recorded in two channels. This the bass in the center, mm-hmm. guitar in the one channel, and percussion, I don't know, like, but the drum stereo, he divided in two channels. And after, I recorded the strings, no? The session strings, and another channel, the voice. Mm. But the synthesizer effects, mm-hmm. we put in the mix to gain more one channel. Mm. Yeah? Mm-hmm. During the mix, have a sound of the synthesizer mm-hmm. simultaneously the mix.
So you overdub the synthesizer?
Yeah.
You record that later?
In real time.
Oh, real time.
In real time during the mix. Mm. Don't have mistake.
Wow. Don't, yeah, if you messed that up.
Yeah. Mm. But the result it was good. You know? Mm-hmm. The sound was very careful.
Yeah, yeah. Shall we play? I wanted to play another song here too. That's a little bit more up tempo, called Sylvia, and maybe we can talk about that as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
You can show the.
Oh wait, let's start this again.
In this recording, this record was recorded, everybody together.
All in the
only
same room.
Only one session, ping. Don't have dub, then nothing of, make the solo after, not solo after. Everybody sing that happened one time. Mm. Mm-hmm. And I was maestro, mm-hmm. no, conductor of TV, Globo TV in the Brazil, uh-huh. and have a trombone named Maciel, Crazy Maciel. Maciel is maluco, Maciel maluco, Crazy Maciel, but
okay.
Name is Edmundo Maciel. Uh-huh. Edmundo Maciel is a type of legend of musician. Huh? Mm-hmm. He was in the second trombone of band of TV. He was not happy to every time or rending. Part, yeah, parts. Mm-hmm. But he wanted to play, but to external all the potential of your music, but don't have market for this. And I call Maciel, have one solo for you. It's 9 o'clock tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Please, you can make a good solo for me. Mm-hmm. And Maciel, oh. Wait a minute, I go to the bar.
Got a drink of
cachaça. I came back,
rehearsal.
Myself, Arthur, please, a moment. I go down.
Go down to the bar again.
I come back, rehearsal more, three times, good. I got to put the solo of Marcel in the final trombone solo, because you'll see that the musician years.
They do better because he is blowing so hard, huh? Mm-hmm.
You can put the last solo of Marcel now of this music. Uh-huh. No, play.
Play it? Okay, you want to play it? Okay, got you. let's see.
But
so the last minute or
no,
so?
No, that music.
Yeah.
That last music.
The last minute or
Karina.
So?
Karina.
Okay, all right. Oh, this one? Karina?
This one, Karina.
The one that we were just playing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like this? Oh, yeah. Is this solo? Maciel. Woo! Maciel.
So I guess what you're saying is sometimes you gotta let them get what they need to get in order to get what you need to get. They need to drink up a little bit so you can get a great solo. Yeah?
Yeah, great solo.
So in the cases where you're doing production work, You're working with a huge number of musicians, many, many musicians in this particular piece. How do you get them, you know, prepared?
In this piece?
Yes, in this piece.
This piece have a trio, no? Mm-hmm. Great musicians. And a trio of bass and two percussions. Elio Del Miro, great guitarist. Luis Alves, bass. Roberto Silva, mm-hmm. Robertinho Silva, drum. Pedro Sorongo, Roberto Silva, percussion. Pascoal Meirelles, drums. And Nivaldo Ornelas, mm-hmm. sax tenor. Mm-hmm. And Maciel, mm-hmm. Sax trombone. Mm-hmm. Don't have much people in that track.
Wow, it sounds like a lot. You make it sound very big sound with the arrangements.
It's the way of to write to horns. Mm-hmm. They have a way to don't need more much people to make mm-hmm. this effect. Mm-hmm. To separate the voices more distance. I like more great sound, more. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Understand?
Yes, definitely. So over the years, you ended up doing a lot of arrangements for many artists, Gal Costa, Georgie Ben, Marcos Val. How is that different from the work that you did for this particular record?
But this record, I am free. I produce. Don't have anything to say me. Do this. Mm-hmm. Anybody mm-hmm. say nothing to me. Make nothing. Mm. I make all my way. Mm-hmm. Is that the different? Because Gao have his style, and Marcos. It's a good style. It's great singers, and mm-hmm. Marcos is a great composer. Mm-hmm. But is that your styles, no?
Yeah.
Not my style.
Yeah.
I have to adapt to mm-hmm. each styles, to each. To I cannot to change. Mm-hmm. No, each singer, style mm-hmm. singer. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And you said that, you were saying that what was maybe disappointing was the way that the record was received by the marketers.
This
yeah,
record.
Your album. Yeah.
Yeah, because I have this track, example, this Karina, is a track totally free, you know, totally without commercial call, no? Mm-hmm. recall.
Yeah.
But and the people don't understand this. No? The people want to money. No? Mm-hmm. The companies want to live with money. Mm-hmm. And they said that Verocai is crazy, you know, mm. make this sound, this record. Mm.
Mm-hmm. Or did they just couldn't understand what you were trying to do?
Yeah, it's this album not to have many sold, many good sales, vendor.
Sales.
And became too sleepy during the years.
You called it a sleeping giant, I think you called it, huh?
Yeah, uh-huh. Sleeping giant. You know, 30 years after, mm-hmm. the giant wake up.
30 years. And now it's all over the world, though. Now everybody kind of sees
Japan, Europe, and mm-hmm. Europe. Huh? Mm-hmm. And
did that discourage you, though? Did you decide that you wanted to move away from the music industry after the experience with your album? Or were you still
Right?
Were you still making music after the album, or did you kind of leave it slowly?
I go to advertising market to make music, to jingles and scores,
commercials and that kind of thing. To
same products.
You were saying
I made a studio, record studio, and I work in the record studio to give me more time to, more comfort to work. And make the jingles and.
Yeah.
During the years, but time and time one around him here on the but few.
Yeah, yeah. But now you're actually back to making a lot of music.
I understand.
I'm
back
now.
Mm-hmm.
Who have you been working with more recently?
I recording album to Far Out, no?
Uh-huh.
It will be released in the March next year, March.
Mm-hmm.
Produced by David Brinkworth.
Mm-hmm.
And with my songs, have two singers, strings, horns, percussion. Will be released in March.
Mm-hmm.
And I released an album, a domestic album, in 2002, with songs of my, like the style of Bossa Nova style. I have some here, if you want. If anybody wants, I have some in the bags.
I think there's a lot of people that will want that.
and I'm making some two classical pieces to guitar, and composing to guitar. I have an album here to parts. For a guitar solo,
I see.
If you want, anybody want to play guitar solo?
Anybody?
Have 90 pieces in this album.
Wow!
But it's the music writing, you know, writing. And that's all. I composing to guitar. I have in the Unirio, University of Rio de Janeiro, of music. Prelude in the curriculum of the university,
right?
Like by me.
So people are now studying your work.
People are studying formally. Yeah. And I love to compose to guitars and four guitars, simultaneous quartet of guitars and quartet of core or strings. And I love to compose. It's my life.
One of the things that you've been doing has been to, just as many of us of a new generation have been turned onto your music, it seems that you've been going back to some of that music as well, and you had made some new arrangements for some of the music that you had made before. Shall we play some of that? The guitar music?
What?
The CD?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Should we play the original first? I think.
I make an arrangement to four guitars, no? The Silvio, no?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is it? Not this one. Wait. What was the track?
Put Karina, because I maybe it's changed.
Yeah, they got the titles mixed up on the cover. So, put Karina like this one, the one that we had played before.
Yeah, Karina was the.
We'll put the CD track 2. Is that the one?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
No, because this is Scottish.
Okay.
How do you work with the new technology now? How do you incorporate that into what you do now?
The new technology is like invention of the electricity, mm-hmm. the light, no?
Mm-hmm.
Light.
Mm-hmm. It's a breakthrough. It's
something. Change
everything.
Everything, uh-huh. you know?
Yeah.
Because today we have a symphonic orchestra in the computer.
In the computer.
Mm-hmm. You have all the instruments to have parts, taking the mouse, mm-hmm. create notes, phrases, and create everything.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a new world
mm-hmm.
to travel.
Mm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And we go inside this world.
Mm. And, you know, many artists have actually use technology to sample a lot of your old songs.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that? I know many artists have mixed feelings about that.
At first moment, I'm feeling very grateful and very, very good, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Because I have people like my work and using my work. I'm mm-hmm. very glad with mm-hmm. this. And, but I have some people who,
mm-hmm.
who don't have authorization and use the work.
Mm.
But it's the world is like, is this. No, we can't change these things.
Mm. So it's sort of a partly good and partly bad. You're happy that younger folks are listening to your music and introducing it to their peers, but at the same time, a lot of artists are taking your music.
For example, that guy who...
MF Doom?
No.
Or Alphonte from Little Brother?
Little Brother Master,
yeah.
No?
Uh-huh.
Little Brother Master use, no? Take a little piece, a little
uh-huh.
of the music, no?
Yeah.
For eight measures.
Mm-hmm.
And create a lyric, another lyric, and
mm-hmm.
put a drum, speed, more
speed, it
speed
up. Uh-huh.
Speak up.
Mm-hmm.
And use
and pay you
very
for
well.
It.
Pay,
yeah.
Uh-huh. Very, very good.
Yeah. Uh-huh. It's the other ones that don't pay you that.
Yeah.
Not
yeah,
so good.
Have, yeah. Not so good. MF Doom.
MF Doom.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to say.
If you're listening, MF Doom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But don't hate to take the introduction of the horns.
Mm-hmm.
Take the middle of the music.
Mm-hmm.
And more. Internet. I received an email of a fan. Who
told you?
Verocai.
Uh-huh.
This guy. Make two songs with your song. go there. I go to listen, I release.
Yeah.
Have the introduction of Seriado, this album.
Uh-huh.
Seriado and Na Boca do Sol.
Uh-huh.
He take the introduction, the middle of the... And make a...
Make something new out of
a
it.
Mix, yeah. Mistura tudo.
Mm-hmm.
And make your songs.
Mm. uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, let's play the Little Brother track since they paid you for it and see what that sounds like. Yeah, yeah. So they took the yeah. Uh-huh.
Speed up.
Yeah, cut it up a little bit.
Yeah.
Mm. We want to open it up to the floor for folks to ask you questions. Is that okay? People from the floor to ask questions? Anybody want to lead off here? Questions at all? Here, in the back. Let's get him a microphone.
Hello. So forgive me because it's the first time I'm discovering your music. So I'm really it's extraordinary because I'm a big fan of Frank Zappa. You know?
Frank Zappa.
Yeah, Frank Zappa. And the music we listen here is really close to Frank Zappa music. The sound, the arrangement. But I don't say you copy Frank Zappa. But I would like to know how you discover Frank Zappa, and if you meet him when it was and where.
Do you think that is too much like Frank Zappa?
Sorry?
Like, I don't understand your question. It's like Frank Zappa.
Yeah, it's really close.
It's a copy, Frank Zappa.
No, not copy. No. it's a surprise for me because a Brazilian guy like you is doing music like Frank Zappa. And I would like to know how it's possible, you know?
No, I listened for Zappa in that time, in 69, 70, 71, maybe. I listened for Zappa, he played guitar, wow, guitar, huh? And give me influence. Mm-hmm. I am very grateful to Frank Zappa. He gave me...
That was your microphone.
This music that the trombone play, yeah. Is that music that have more influence of Frank Zappa, maybe? Mm. I think, but after this, become jazz. And I became jazz. And
so putting together Frank Zappa and then that sort of a jazz
mixed the things, not
mixing it all.
And I don't know how make this, but
but here it is. Did the other question was, had you ever gotten to meet Frank Zappa? Did you ever meet Frank Zappa when he went to Brazil?
No, I never met Frank Zappa. Mm. Mm-hmm. I was listening to Frank Zappa, and I don't remember what album Frank Zappa I had, because the album, the people go to my house, take the album, but that, they don't remember more. They have no more this album.
Maybe we're only in it for the money or something.
the music we have listened before remind me the album The Grand Wazoo and the Hot Rats.
The Grand Wazoo.
The Hot Rats. The album from 71 and 73.
Maybe. I record this 72, no? Maybe 71.
Hmm. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Over here.
It seems to me that it's jazz, but it's fewer chords, like one or two chords maybe, or more in the melody, and then when it comes to solos, maybe one or two chords to really open up, like more, not modal, but...
Please, speak slow, because I don't understand.
Do you prefer less chords in the music to express more?
Less chords? What less chords?
As opposed to more jazz with many, many chords, like in the form, like maybe chord progressions, less chords in the progression?
Less
chords.
Fewer
chords. He's saying to him, your music sounds like jazz, but fewer chords.
Ah, fewer chords. These songs that you said, yeah, it's jazz in my conception is a performance by the musician, it's improvised. And we, in that time, is a form of jazz because it's not traditional jazz. That time is a new jazz, the new jazz players are improvising in only one chord. Because they have the, he rest in one chord, resting in a chord. And it's more difficult because not to have many scales to use, to improvise. Nah, have one idea in the mind to improvise in one chord, to have more idea to improvise in one chord than 20 chords.
Yeah, it seems like that's what you're trying to push for, more expression from the players, from your band. Like you want chord, possibly more, the players can express more, maybe say what they're trying to say musically easier through one chord than as opposed to other jazz that I've listened to with many chords.
Because there's fewer chords, do you think that your musicians can be more expressive in what they are playing?
No, I think not. It's fewer chords is the time, the mode, fashion of this time. Good one.
Thank you for the music, first of all.
Thank you.
When you compose primarily, do you work from the guitar onto the rest of the instruments?
Yeah, I have manners to compose. No, I compose with the mouse, I compose with the guitar, maybe piano. I now in the few years to ago, I compose with the mouse because mouse don't have instrument to jail me. Entendeu? Então, when the mouse, you are free with the part. And the mind is free of to think about the subconscient, inconscient, to play and to create.
You visualize the sounds? And
yeah.
How do they come? Colors?
To imagine Johann Sebastian Bach in the century 18th
century.
Yeah. Playing. He don't have mouse, don't have computer. But your mind is great. Mm-hmm. That size. Nah. Wrote without nothing. Nah. But I am the computer to help me. And the computer is very good to it's a, don't, I am free with the computer to make the.
I thought it, what you said was you are jailed by the instrument.
Because the instrument, you are limited. Uh-huh. And,
what you can physically do.
Yeah, physically. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You are limited physically. Mm-hmm. Because when you think about music, you will think simultaneously about the finger, about the hair, the where I go. But have music that out spontaneous. Out, have music that you follow. I pick the better. This out spontaneously,
right?
Like improvise,
right?
But with it's only melody, one melody with the harmony. But when have four voices, four instruments simultaneous, the violin is not good to compose because you don't get
you can't get it all.
All the voices,
at one time, But I guess a question related to that is, in the style of bossa nova, it's really guitar based, yeah? And so do you find, since you come with the bossa nova foundation, that when you approach the computer, you bring that to what you're making on the computer?
Bossa nova? Okay. No. Bossa nova don't use guitar bass.
No?
Bossa nova use acoustic bass.
Acoustic, okay.
In the beginning, no?
Yeah.
Don't have guitar bass in that time. It was acoustic bass, because acoustic bass is used in the jazz.
Uh-huh.
No? And bossa nova is same jazz, it's like jazz.
Mm-hmm. I guess maybe another way to ask the question is, does an instrument influence the way that you make the music or the way that you compose? Does that make sense?
Yeah, the guitar is a great instrument to compose bossa nova. Mm. Mm-hmm. If not exist a guitar, not exist bossa nova.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Bossa nova is a guitar. Uh-huh. Guitar is a fundamental instrument to bossa nova. Mm-hmm. João Gilberto adapted the samba beat, né? The tambourine, tick 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 tick, and the bass make the surdo. Let's go. Bossa nova.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Tom Jobim makes the.
Yeah.
But thank you very much. Bossa nova. But the guitar, I have an instrument to make another type of music, like this. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much.
He just presented an entire history of the last 100 years of Brazilian music in the last 10 minutes, yeah. Right here. That was beautiful. Thank you. Yeah. Were there enough chords there? I think there were enough.
Yeah, this team is Filhos, Sons, the name. Mm. Lyrics by Paulinho Tapajós. It's a new album of Far Out.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Ivan Lins sing this. Song.
So that's going to be on the new record.
New record.
Yeah. That's beautiful. Thank you. Other questions? Ben.
You mentioned James Bach before. I'm just wondering whether there are any other classical composers that you say were influences upon your arrangements or upon your compositions?
Classical.
Yeah.
I don't get to play because I mix with the mouse, but yeah. The American Prelude. Difficult to me to play this song.
I guess my question was in terms of when you're doing an arrangement or making a composition, are any of the other composers an influence upon you? For example, I read an interview one time or saw an interview with somebody talking about Tom Rubin, saying that he was very much influenced by Chopin. Do you have any influences like that?
Tom Jobim? Yeah, Tom Jobim have many influences to French music, to Debussy, Ravel. And Chopin, no more, no much. Have more Debussy, he listened
Debussy. Mm-hmm.
Many Debussy, Ravel, this type of more impressionists. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But I don't understand your question.
Well, for you, are there any other classical composers that have influenced you?
Yeah, I have. I love Bach. I love Villa-Lobos, Brazilian composer. And all the composer that I listen, I think that influenced to me. No, I love Chopin too. I love. Debussy, Ravel, all the composers. No? I don't like too much the classical period, Mozart. You know? I don't like too much because don't have too much with me that or do my music. But I like more Villa-Lobos. The first music you have in this.
On the CD?
The CD, yeah.
Okay.
Is a example of Villa-Lobos and Bach mixed.
Shall we play that?
Yeah.
Shall we play?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, no. I recorded the two in my house. The two guitars.
You recorded both guitars?
Yeah.
It was for two, he was saying during the break, it was a piece for two guitars and very influenced by Debussy, right? Is that what you say?
Influenced?
No? What did you say?
Yeah, I have Debussy influenced too.
Mm-hmm.
The beginning is more Villa Lobos. No?
Ah, I see.
I have a that's the I just want to say bah it's a mix.
Mixing it up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
The question over here. Oh, we should get on the microphone though. Yeah?
I want to ask about any capoeira influences.
What?
Capoeira.
Capoeira?
Brazil is like a country of.
Yeah, capoeira is a game.
Yeah, I know, but they have special music, right?
Yeah, capoeira is a folkloric game, you know?
Yeah, do you ever, like, you and capoeira?
Yeah, capoeira. My son played capoeira, my son. Baden Powell, a great guitarist, Brazilian guitarist who died, make the berimbau. It's an instrument of capoeira.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's making this song. Wonderful. But I never composed with this instrument, berimbau. Mm. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Question up here, Torsten.
When we wonder what makes the music of you or Georgie Ben or Shimaya so beautiful, and we really do admire your musicianship, but there's one chord that always comes up, and it is, hey, all we tried to do was to simplify the Beatles. Can you probably explain that a little bit?
Well, the artists, your work, Chimaya, Georgie Ben, were all influenced by the Beatles and trying to simplify the Beatles for Brazil, I suppose.
Chimaya?
Yeah?
Simplify the Beatles?
You think?
No, I think Chimaya. Timaya was a great singer. He is more soul music, né? Because quando o inverno chegar, te primavera, te amo, te amo. It's more soul than the lemon pump down. Chimaya is more swingy. Mm-hmm. And Beatles is more white music. No? It's very beautiful.
Which is what makes that song for us always like much richer.
Huh?
Which was why the quote always was so confusing to us, because it sounds so much richer and yet like
rich.
Well, the Brazilian music sounds so much more rich, colorful, you know, than the Beatles.
Beatles, I think each guy give your message. Mm. Nah, all the music is very good. Beatles, Beatles is the Beatles. Nah, you don't Lennon, Paul McCartney, great composers. Nah. Nah, they give song, no, everybody like of this. universal song, the world, every word like this, you know. But music, Brazilian music is have many tendencies, many influences. You have Afro influences, have Arabic influences, because Iberic, Peninsula Iberica, Spain and Portugal was invaded by the Arabs,
right.
No?
Mm-hmm.
And the music.
North African.
Yeah. In the northeastern of Brazil, the Baião, they have many. Have many influence. They have many influence Arabian, no?
Yeah, the voice.
And they have influence of Indians, no? And indigenous,
yeah.
And it's a product of many people, no? Many cultures. Brazilian music, European too. No? The chorinho, no? Chorinho is an example of this European music, no? Chorinho, no? Harmony and melody, European but Afro rhythm.
Rhythm.
Can you give us some more examples of like how, especially when it comes to harmony and rhythm, like you can use whatever European thing, and as soon as it lands in Brazil, something beautiful can emerge.
Oh, Tom Jobim, harmony. Vejo Rio de Janeiro. Estou morrendo de saudade. Rio de Janeiro. It's European harmony, but the samba. It's black, no? It's Afro influence.
For someone who wants to learn to play the samba on a guitar, it's something mostly really hard because the rhythm, it looks so easy when you go see people play it and then all of a sudden you're like...
No, it's very easy.
Can you give us a few tricks?
No, you'll at first to learn one position only. Then. And after go to step by step learning. Music is step by step.
What are the first 5 steps that you want?
The 5 steps? Don't.
You have to sign up for the class that he teaches.
It's only step by step. Music is because the people is not adapted. Now the Charles Darwin said, the origin of the species. This book will change the think of the humanity. Huh? Mm. That the animal adapted to ambience, no? Mm. And the man who adapted to instrument, but step by step, not one day for another day. The adaptation is quotidian.
You gotta get out of the water before you can walk, I guess. more questions. Benji, back here. Okay.
Hi. A really significant part of your music is
the string arrangement.
Yeah.
And I just wondered if you could talk a little bit about string arrangement and at what point in the composition that comes and how you go about it. And I also wondered whether we might be able to listen to the original version of Sylvia,
mm-hmm.
And maybe use that as a case study, because that's one of my favorite examples.
What's the question?
The question is, with the strings, he loves the strings.
Yeah,
he wants to know when you add the strings to a composition, when does that come in? Does it come last? Do you put that
after?
In
this music, Silvio example. Silvio was, I was making the album, and I have only 9 musics, but have to be 10 songs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And what I do now, and I make in the studio, making in my house. In one day after, before, the harmonic sequence, no? This bass. I go to my house to think about what I do now. and I made. But not have planned never nothing to plan in this case. Mm-hmm. It was really improvised.
Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm.
This music. Shall it's spontaneous, no?
Shall we play it?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me see if we can get this. And the thing about the record, when you go and get it, is that all of the songs have the wrong titles on them. This is what I'm just figuring out now. So I think this is on, let me see if we got this. You said that you had done that spontaneously. It just came to you.
I put 4 trumpets, no? In the one flute,
mm-hmm.
making the. I became super modern conception,
mm-hmm.
of that today is modern today.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
30 years well, after.
We're catching up now.
Yeah. And this in the end have a flute,
right.
Improvise like I listened a song by Jethro Tull by it's Bach, no? But Jethro Tull this.
Yeah.
They play with. I just said to Oberda, make the improvise with song simultaneous together. And Oberda use this effect in the record because the Jethro Tull. I listened in the Jethro Tull song.
Jethro Tull was another influence. Just, all right. Who was talking about the Jethro Tull match last night?
And the strings was used in the bass region, the violins, and the people use the violins in the tremble, in the region, and have shocks. Many shocks, two minor segunda menor, semitone, okay. Semitone.
Yeah.
And they give atmosphere different. A
little more depth to the sound and space, breath to the sound. Mm.
And the drums is not a convention drums, because the place is ting, 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 it's a problem over by working the
tom toms,
and
cymbals.
Cymbals and psss, psss, ting, good, psss, got to go, paka, taka, paka, got to go, psss, got to go, psss. Everybody, and the percussion. Have a samba percussion, pack to do to tato agogô. Have um agogô, Robertinho plays. Robertinho plays samba in this. Porque tac to do to tato do to tac to do to tato do to. It's a pearl of percussion. But is he created? Created. Not I don't wrote this. Take to do to, no?
Yeah.
Percussion was free. They feel this.
Just like I said, catching up now. We're just catching up now. The samba, the Bach, the Jethro Tull.
Jethro Tull. Music is a mix of everything, you know? It's a carnival. not carnival, but it's a mix, it's beautiful to mix, no? What we'll make a cake, no? With butter, milk, eggs, no?
Mix it all up. Other questions, comments, thoughts? Mark? Play Nabogata So? Okay, maybe we can close then with another.
Yeah.
Oh, here, we have a question over here. Emma?
This is very
okay.
Quick thing. I just wondered if we could possibly hear you play one more thing.
What?
Could you play one more piece of music on
the one more music?
Please.
What? My fingers are sleeping yet. Don't I not get to. But I.